All right, we're live, I think it's working, and it's sideways, so it did it right. So here's the deal, guys. We're at Bow Tie Street Food, and look here, taco combo, $7. That's two tacos. What else?
Chips and salsa.
Taco salad, $8. Quesadilla, $8. That's a good deal on a quesadilla. Or as we say in hillbilly land, quesadilla or something.
Quesadilla.
I'll take one of those.
Is it quesadilla today? You want beef or chicken? Chicken? How's your weekend?
It was okay.
It was good. Depends on how big of a ball fan you were, I think. I'm glad I didn't go to the game, I'll say that.
Oh, yeah, that's hammering.
I felt horrible for the people that were there. I was like, Butch Jones, if you're listening,
I'm disappointed, man.
Yeah, he's professional now. He's gotten big time.
He makes a mean quesadilla.
I tell you what, it looks delicious. I'm going to have one later.
It's my favorite off of this menu, I will say that.
What a beautiful day.
It is gorgeous, isn't it?
I want the rain. I really don't want to mow anymore. I definitely don't. I'm done mowing every 4 to 5 days.
I'm tired of mowing.
Let the grass die off. I don't know.
John, you're right. It's a good day to be slinging. Hey, Jeff. Glad you're with us.
How's the business?
It's been good today. For a beautiful, I mean, usually the better the weather, actually, for me, the slower it is here. But it's been pretty steady so far.
Have you always been Bow Tie Street Food?
We've been Bow Tie and Hot Dogs was the original name. And then we've actually changed our name twice. For a very short stint, when I was building out a trailer, we switched to Bow Tie Food Truck, and then we switched to Bow Tie Street Food Catering. Well, Blair wanted to do some new shirts and some new logos and such, so she wanted to do all the change at once. Big thing, the reason we did it was when you contact festivals and such, and you have hot dogs in your name, they may just send an automatic reply like, we already got a hot dog guy.
Like, not really, Tammy.
We do a lot of other stuff, you know, so.
It's the menu that I listed a minute ago. Hey, Leanne. Your quesadilla is going to be famous with like 7 and 8s of people. Tammy, he's working on a catered roast. He's got this Blackstone griddle up here. And he ran it on a separate tank so he can use this on his catering gig separately if he wants.
Yeah, I actually don't even need a cart. I have actually, when my one cart went down, you were here that one day, right, where I was set up on a table, I think doing burgers on this grill.
Maybe.
But I don't even know if they noticed. I put a table, 6-foot table down, put the griddle on it, and went to work.
That's the way to do it. That'll work.
I'll be back right. We're doing cheesesteaks and Dewey, I think.
Hey, how's it going?
Doing good. How are you doing?
Good. Yeah, I'm just going to get the taco combo, please.
What do you want today? Chicken or ground beef for you?
Chicken, please.
Chicken?
Yeah. We have a new bag of cheese out here. I'll be right back.
Oh, okay. You said, what's up, meat with it?
Chicken.
Chicken? Or do you want one of each, or?
No, chicken's fine.
All right.
Y'all be right back.
I'll get them ready for you. The only thing...
Jeff, he's in Knoxville. Go ahead, Matt. What'd you say?
Is when I picked this one out used.
Right.
I bought it from South Carolina.
Right.
So it's got the reverse cooler on it. When I originally went and picked it up, it had the big old thing.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And they said, oh, yeah, it's good to go down the road. And I guess it wasn't strapped up right or something. We made it, like... 5 miles down the road, and I look behind me, and the thing just flying off on the highway, and I'm like, I'm not turning around.
Nope. I wouldn't either.
And I was like, I wasn't going to use it anyway.
So you just got one of the steam tables as a cold bay, right?
Correct.
So he's got cold stuff here. His sour cream, lettuce he buys already pre-shredded. And the cheese is shredded. And has ice under that. And so really the only thing you've got on is this, right?
Correct.
The only thing he's got running. That was good info about Name Hot Dog in the festivals. I'm having an appointment Friday to buy a card. I was going to call it EZ's Hot Dogs, but now it's EZ's Catering. There you go, brother.
Yeah.
There you go.
Everyone that's coming to visit with me, I've talked to them about their name. And a big thing is, Jason preaches it all the time, pigeonholing is a real thing. And it's not that I'm against putting, I love hot dogs. You know, putting it in your name, though. You can contact events, and it's just, they're like, well, we already got a hot dog guy. And I'm like, well, wait a minute, you know.
Right.
We do lemonade. We do, you know, tacos. We do, you know, cheesesteak. And then they're like, well, yeah, we need that. You know? This location, I usually do about 2 hours and about 11 to 1. And depending on whether it's a, if payday was Friday or not.
Right.
This is a non-one. We'll do anywhere from like 40 to 50, 60 people here in 2 hours.
So not bad.
On the average of 8 plus some tips and stuff. So it's a good Tuesday, and I'm home to pick up the kids or whatever. So
I'll show that menu again. This is location, Jeff, is a bank call center. First Tennessee Bank in Knoxville, Tennessee. And here's Bowtie Street Food. You see that taco combo 7, taco salad 8, quesadilla 8. And this is a used Cater Pro that he picked up out of South Carolina. And he's also got a new Cater Pro. And you got another one, right? What's the other one? A cash cow?
All-American.
All-American cart. And
that's the shame of the family.
I wouldn't say that. He's got three carts to use, and he's had to use them.
Next step's a trailer or a truck, though, I think. That's for sure at this point.
Jeff, I like that. Morning Ray Catering. Leanne says, working on my name and logo now, going with Slay Dogs Catering and Mobile Vending. Love that.
So that's $7. You get two tacos, chips and salsa. A lot of the food trucks around Knoxville for tacos that really, I think mine are better. We'll charge almost $4 to $5 per taco. I'll do them 2 for $5 or, you know, do the combos, two and chips and salsa for $7.
That's a good value. $7?
I try to do a good value, and that's what keeps these folks coming out. You can, when you're dealing with businesses like this, you can slaughter them once or shear them,
right.
You know, I try to give a good value for a good price,
right,
and good amount of food, you know, so they're not hungry or anything.
Ben and says he loves bow tie.
It's finally getting the temperature where I can get out of my bow tie t-shirts and back into actual bow ties, so this summer, you know, the summer is just too hot for it.
Oh, doggy says hello.
What is happening, Corey?
He said, Luke says that's a big portion, man.
Yeah, but it's really not. I mean, total cost on that, I charge $7. Total cost is about $1.58, I think, is not including tax. But
right,
you know,
right.
That's actual food cost on it. It's really not that expensive at all.
That's good to know. See, y'all got valuable information right there. We're at a fair on Mount Eagle Monday. Somebody said, I'm just going down these. I'm sorry if the camera's moving around. I'm trying to move my finger across these comments. Not here. Some places do want it covered, but see, the umbrella, a 9-foot umbrella, they'll count as covering because it stops from overhead debris. Some states like South Carolina, and this cart came from South Carolina, you see this rail that a plexiglass cover over it, which kind of makes a petri dish of sorts out of your cart. It's the stupidest thing. South Carolina is the only state that requires that. And it goes against FDA Chapter 4 guidelines, which is even stupider.
I used to do tents here, but as they can attest to, I've lost 2 tents this year.
Blowing.
Just because of somehow it's like we're in this thing, but wind gusts will come real strong up against this building. And I've lost 2 tenths with weights on them. It is picked up, slammed down, legs broken, everything. One I had to break to pieces just to get it back in the truck. How you doing today?
Oh, I can't complain.
The beautiful day
that was
out.
$7 for the whole meal that he showed you. $7 for the whole meal. And most of the taco trucks around here are $4 to $5 per taco, and they don't come with the salad and salsa. Or the chips and salsa, sorry.
No dairy, I got you. That's my type of taco.
Hey, Mary.
Well,
hey, David. Jeff, the cost that per taco, whole meal, that was the whole meal. That cost, not including tax, but his price includes tax. So it was, yeah, that was the whole meal. Total food cost. And you sound clear. Good. I'm glad I'm sounding clear. The cart I'm looking at is Vince Cart's 09 with big bicycle tires. Four sinks. Grab them. 15 is at a good price. I've never seen a big dog with bicycle tires. The little dog has it, but the big dog, I've never seen that. It seems like too much weight unless they put on really, really good commercial, like, you know, carnival tires.
This is a taco salad. Normally, she wanted no cheese or sour cream. Normally, there'd be a bunch of cheese underneath the pico and sour cream right on top there. Crunch up chips, lettuce, and top it with...
That pico's gorgeous.
No, the pico is... We sell it here occasionally by the pint. If you let them know ahead of time, you know,
right.
Usually once a month I'll do it. It means I got to do more tomatoes, so...
Hey, Warren, glad you're here. David Rambo's in the house. So, for those that don't know, we are in Knoxville, Tennessee, and we're in front of the First Tennessee Bank call center, and this is a big plaza, okay? It's got a Gold's Gym at the other end. It's off a road called Chapman Highway that runs from Sevierville to Knoxville, and you can see how the employees that are in this call center, and this is, used to be an old Walmart, and Matt comes up here for a couple hours and does this Taco Tuesday. Then he'll do Taco Tuesday tonight in front of the Beard and Beer Garden. And you can see he leaves the truck hooked up. He's just right at the front door. They walk out and bam, there he is.
Downtown area.
Okay. So
he's one of some of
you. Okay.
So I'm going to go ahead and just grab that one.
So. Okay. So just like... I don't have any of the plastic containers with me today, but that's I can put it in one of these.
That's fine.
Yeah, it would, Mark. Jalapenos. Hey, Sue. Bob's in the house. Bob, man. Cliff Wright. What kind of cart? That's a Cater Pro cart. And he's got the Blackstone sitting on the side. He's got the other Cater Pro, too, with the built-in griddle, but he's using this one today, and... He hadn't even taken the people's logos off of it, so his wife built this cool skirt around the cart. Goes all the way around and covers the other logos.
Yeah, these are out today. I get scared. Winter's coming.
Yeah.
Farmer's Almanac's at Almanac's.
Definitely cold one. A little bit cooler than it has been the last couple of days.
Oh, yeah. I'm fine with that, though. I'm ready for chicken and dumplings and soup. And Blair's all ready to do the soup menu
grilled
again.
Cheese.
Do your grilled cheese. Bring the grilled cheese back.
I'm just using my phone on a stick, John.
I
just found a stick on the side of the road and took some duct tape and hooked up my phone. I'm just kidding, though. It's one of the handheld phone holder thingies. Look how pretty that looks.
Bye.
That's what I was telling Candace, you know, you can do anything on these griddles. I mean, you can do Cuban sandwiches, you can do anything. Cubish is here in Knoxville. They have a King Chaos.
Yeah.
And he does a Cuban off of his griddle. And he just does a wrapped brick to press it.
Just aluminum foil wrap brick?
Yeah.
Yeah, smart.
Put it right there and put it on. You can do it with the grill weight too. It's not expensive. I've got a couple cast iron grill weights.
How are you?
Good.
What is happening?
Not a lot. What we got today?
We're doing the taco menu today. Taco Tuesday.
I know that. I never know what you got left. See, the loaded nachos are already gone, so that's why I asked.
No, they're still here. Blair had marked them off Friday night. We went to this school event Friday.
Yeah.
And we served over 100 people. And I didn't really think it was going to be anything. Yeah, it turned out to be really. We ran out, and I felt so bad because we had a line from here to that car over there. And we ran out. And that line, okay, the other food truck that was with him was a friend of ours, and he had a line about the same length. And so our line, we ran out, we sold out, and our line had to go out and get in the, I felt horrible.
Oh,
I mean, Blair,
my goodness.
Like, all weekend was feeling bad about it.
Oh, yeah.
I love it.
Hi. Hey, how are you?
Good.
Thank you much.
All right, so we're going to do...
Oh, Tammy uses the covered grill brick. That's cool. Jason, he is in Knoxville, Tennessee, in front of the First Tennessee Bank call center, which is off Chapman Highway.
He's the camera crew for Next Top Model.
Work it, girl. Work it. Work it. Here's my Zoom.
He's just doing the background video, so when I go on, I'm going to...
There you go.
It'll be my background, you know, when they tell about my life.
Yeah, okay.
How many days that we do crazy hair
day? Yeah, right? Unfortunately, I'm crazy every day, so there we go. Tacos.
You want chicken or ground beef or one of each?
You didn't do pork.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, I meant to do pork today.
Yeah, you did.
I didn't mean to do pork today. I'm sorry. You'll have to forgive me. I'll do them next week. I promise. I think Blair's even listening right now. So Blair, yeah. Your
pork. Let's do beef.
Beef. Yeah, we'll do pork sometimes too. Ground pork tacos. It works out really good. They usually sell out. I usually only do like 3 pounds of those because they're not as popular as chicken or beef, but people do like them. And it is good. I like it in the quesadilla. What you hungry for today? Chicken or ground beef?
Chicken. Earl, I'll ask in a minute.
How I turn both left and right?
And right. Earl wanted to know about, how do you know how much to get for a supply run and how much waste you have a day?
Well, the great thing about Tuesday is I do tacos all day. So I'll be doing tacos for lunch, and then I'll go to dinner tonight and do tacos again. And usually I'll try to do tacos like on Wednesday too. Tomorrow I will be doing Philly cheesesteaks though at my location. So they requested them, so we'll be doing them specifically tomorrow. We're doing them Friday.
Yeah. We're doing them Friday?
Yeah.
Okay.
Philly cheesesteak Friday.
Yum yum.
Yeah, I'm doing Philly cheesesteak, I think.
So not much waste. You've pretty much got it down where you know about what you have.
Running out isn't the worst thing in the world. I mean, it is, it's, you know.
Well, this lady gets upset if you run out.
Exactly.
Well, really, ideally, I'll tell you, actually, I'm okay if I run out after she gets here. So she's kind of my clock, too. I kind of know what, in general, what time it is.
Unless I show up an hour early.
Well, that does happen. Like, one time she threw me, like, way off. Like, I'm like...
Is it that time already?
It can't be 1 o'clock already.
Yeah, no, I'm a little early. So...
I'll show you, Tim, the menu here in just a second. He's got it out front on the cart. Oh, look at this. This is service. Bowtie Street Food, see? And you can see Taco Combo 7, Taco Salad 8, Quesadilla 8, And the one that's scratched out, which actually is in stock, is Loaded Nachos.
Yes.
Thank you for doing that.
This is one of the only vendors that come here that I eat from.
Really?
And this is, I do it Tuesday and Friday.
See? She's plugging you worldwide.
That's hey.
We're going to have people flying in.
He's got good food.
I eat yours and I eat the pizza.
Pizza's good. I know the pizza.
Yeah, well, when I'm here on Thursday, then I'll eat the pizza. But he's the only one that I eat from. Mm-hmm.
Those two are the only ones that I eat.
Yeah.
That's cool. I like y'all's crazy hair day. One lady come out here with a big flower in her hair. It's bigger than her head.
Yeah. I can't use an excuse I didn't wake up early enough because I'm an hour early. I didn't know how long paying bills was going to take. There's my excuse. The sad thing is I'm dressing up tomorrow in the poodle skirt.
Yeah.
So I had this lady call me and wanted to do an interview with me. And I told her point blank, I said, I'm not really going to be dressed for an interview tomorrow. I'm going to be in 50s style poodle dress. I really don't think that's going to work out real well. Let's do it Thursday. We're only doing interviews on Wednesday. I said, well, I guess I luck out then, huh?
Yeah.
We did a sock hop birthday party a couple weeks ago. And it was so cool because, like, everyone dressed up.
Now, he doesn't cook the pizza, Earl. The pizza's different truck.
It's not a truck. It's a cart.
A pizza cart.
He's got a big
oh, okay.
Dome on it. It's kind of like Jason Brown used to.
Yeah, yeah.
It's called the Brick Oven Pizza. Wood oven pizza.
Okay.
I run into him at GFS all the time. He's a nice guy.
And I'll plug him, too, because he's got awesome food. Yes.
Thank you, Susan.
But there are part two, technically.
Who's Boomer? Mark says.
Boomer?
I don't know.
Huh? Oh, I can just talk about
that.
Boomer Sooner. Yeah, only if you can get Bob to come out of retirement for me. That's all there.
Is your money box bolted down?
He already said this morning. He said yesterday, nope, not happening. Scoops. So...
Right.
I don't know if it is. He's in front of a bank. I would think it's pretty safe here in front of the bank.
Yeah, nobody knows that we're a bank. That's the nice thing. That's the call center.
I generally want, when people roll by, I've had some weird people at the security guard come out warn me too, because sometimes they'll come by and be like, this is a bank, man? And I'll be like, no. No, I think it's over there. Go over there, man.
But your money box isn't bolted down, is it?
No, I've never had a problem. I don't do a lot of high-risk vending, like, at night or anything like that. So...
We've got security cameras outside of it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Literally, there's a guard with a gun right there. And Rick, and he eats with me, like, every day. So.
That's good.
Rick, yeah. Rick's awesome. He's a putty tat, but he'll hurt you.
I mean,
he'll protect you.
Yeah, hurt you. No, there's no protecting.
You gotta know your own area, but you know, I don't do a lot of high risk nighttime, late night vending or anything like that. To be honest, Knoxville doesn't have actually a lot of spots that I would call high risk at all. So, I mean, not realistically, not in broad daylight.
One thing about Matt's food, you never leave hungry.
Yeah, I see. People were commenting on how much he puts on us.
And it's awesome prices. You never leave hungry. If you're not hungry from the time you get done eating his, that's your own fault. Because
it means you dropped half of it.
Yeah, pretty much.
I generally shoot for a quarter, 4 ounces, of meat at minimum for any of my meals. So a quarter pound is a standard meat for almost all my meals. Some of them have more.
Depending on if he likes you or not. No, just kidding.
Right.
Some of them, like a salad, is super heavy. I mean, just due to the pico and everything.
Yeah.
I mean, his quesadilla is a lot bigger than like a quesadilla you'll get.
His salads are rounded in here.
Wow.
It's serious. And it's packed. And you get the meat, the cheese, the chips. Everything that you would get on a taco, you get in the
Right, salad. It's not just the rabbit food.
No, it's not.
You must be sweet today. That little sucker's been around you the whole time.
That's quesadilla setup. Look at that. Sour cream pico chips, a little lettuce underneath there. So just a good setup.
Jason, I think he said 40 to 60.
That depends on what every other Tuesday is busier than the other. Depends if it follows a payday or not.
The only thing that he needs to bring back is the lemonade.
Yeah. Blair's in charge of that. We'll see.
Okay. So,
we were doing them here. We kind of peaked around 6 lemonades. So it's just whether or not Blair wakes up in the morning to make the lemonade.
Okay. All right. Well, I'll
bring them Friday. You want them Friday?
I want them Friday. All right.
We're doing mango tea now, too.
Mango tea? Are you really back?
Good. Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Awesome. Then, yes, I want that.
At the food truck park,
y'all have a good day, too.
6 gallons of mango tea at the food truck park.
Oh, I want to try your mango tea.
It's real good. It's fresh mangoes.
You going to do your mango
syrup,
salsa?
The white peach mango? I'll see. Maybe next Tuesday.
Okay.
So, not Friday, but we'll do it Tuesday.
Alright.
I'd like to make something for myself, too. We got to get packed up and selling, though.
So. Yeah. So, when do you stop, Phil?
I don't stop.
You come in the wintertime?
Yeah, I come in the winter. You weren't here last winter.
No.
Yeah, we start doing soups and grilled cheese. Like, I have a 3-cheese grilled cheese that's, like, really famous in there. But I take Swiss cheddar, and then I make a Parmesan butter garlic mixture, and that spreads on the bread.
Mary, I agree with that.
And then
with the sour cream. In fact, I use a sour cream gun. We gave one away, I think, this past spring on the show. The commercial sour cream gun. It just works some dynamite, and it holds, I think, a 1/2 gallon of sour cream.
I think they're 5 apiece or like 8 for both.
Yeah, Frankenstein Stalker. I was in your neck of the woods this morning, brother. Was going to try to. I know you were off today, so I know you're doing something cool to your cart. So anyway, I'll catch you on the way back through again, because I got something for you.
And we do a chicken and dumpling menu in the winter. I like doing that. I mean, I came out here last year when it was 17 degrees. I just sat up over there, and we put the propane heaters behind the cart. And then the steam from this, it kind of made like a pocket of warmness, and everyone just yelled out the door like, "Hey, Matt, I want
to." Yeah, David. Blair, his wife, did that skirt because this is the older. This is the Kato Pro he found used, and it had the other logo. So he's covering the logos right now with it. But Blair makes these pretty skirts for him, and they look good. I think they're Velcroed on. She's done a good job. I think it looks good. Even if you had logos, it'd still look good. It just makes it look cool. You see the wheels sticking out?
Because 5-10 people makes a huge difference.
And I got the 360 camera still going, I think. Recording, hopefully.
So I actually get like everybody.
Right.
James, I'd love to, brother. I'm going to try. I keep trying. Like, I'm trying on this trip to catch several. So y'all stay tuned and I'll try to get more.
Around in the center.
Oh, okay. So they're moving the center. So the teams.
Yeah.
Because I heard somebody say something about moving.
Earl, I'm going to be all over Missouri. you see that in flip-flops.
Yeah. I wear the flip-flops. Same shoes to church as I wear to Venn, so I can't say much.
All right. Well,
Hey, thanks for talking with us.
Oh, no problem. Obviously, I'm not camera shy. Can you bring in a pork pie?
All right, I'm going to turn this around.
Pork?
And,
we're doing Tuesday.
Oh, that's right.
I'll show you.
Next Tuesday, I'll
what I'm wearing. I'm wearing my...
Take it easy.
I don't know if you can see this, but wearing my Hot Dog Queen shirt. And there's Matt working.
Yeah, something like that.
You're about done, ain't you?
Well, yeah, we'll hit the 1 o'clock. I'll get like 1 or 2 people. I mean, most of my late people kind of came out already, but we'll get 1 or 2 more.
Are you out of sour cream now?
Sour cream, yeah, but they'll still get them regardless.
Some lady...
I should have bought the 5-pound one today instead of
the 3. Do you ever use the gun, the sour cream gun?
No, I've never bought one. I usually just do the dollops and such. So, hey, I'll endorse a product real quick though.
What's that?
This stuff is awesome. Saves you a lot of time too. The restaurant sanitizer.
Pure Ale.
Yeah, buy it at GFS or you might get it at Sam's, but it's sanitizer for restaurants in a bottle. You just spray it down and then wipe it down.
Nice.
Saves you a lot of time from making a bucket or something like that, and it will always meet health code requirements. So, well, at least it will meet my requirements. So. Which, I mean, it's a It's a quaternary sanitizer that stays is shelf stable. So.
Well, cool. Y'all heard that. I'll have to pick some of that up, too.
Yeah, but it's food
service.
I've
not used it.
You know.
I'm using the food service one, but it ain't the Purell.
Yeah, I just spray it down and, you know. And then, of course, not ammonia-based window cleaner. Best cleaner in the world for a car.
At least for quick cleaning.
Right.
I do it in between.
Well, that's food safe, too, though.
Yeah.
I mean, they use that in hospitals.
Yeah. They just spray it down and take all the stains off. I usually do that between everything. They'll just pull out the... that and go from there.
So let me see if we got other. Cliff says love the videos.
Is this on hot dogs or is this on
hot dogs?
United?
Hot dogs.
All right, guys. I'm gonna show you something. I'm gonna go ahead and show you. This is one of my other carts. I just picked this up and I haven't even removed the logos from the other people's things. So I'm gonna show you something truly sad that I consider sad. I picked this cart. This cart brand new from Ben. With the options it's got enabled, I think is about 4,400 or something
right.
Like that. I mean, it's got the extra. Which I love this. Guys, if you get a Cater Pro, get this thing.
The shelf,
this is like my favorite thing in the world. I'm going to show you something real sad about determination and execution. You know, so somebody had a dream, right? Went out and bought a brand new Cater Pro. This thing, if I lift these pans up, you'll see it's not even burnt out yet. I mean, like the box is, the burners still have black on them.
Wow.
I mean, it's crazy.
So they didn't use it?
They didn't use it. It didn't get used at all. I mean, it did not get used at all. It might have been turned on for a home thing. It never got used commercially. She did logoing. She got health certified in South Carolina. All right.
See that?
She had a proper commissary. South Carolina, they have to list their commissary.
See, South Carolina, they have to list their commissary, and there's their commissary listing.
All right, so she got all the hardest work done, right? All the hard work was done. She had a location she wanted to do, and she got told no, which was the state forest park. Which I hate to tell you, the state parks are not going to let you in general. Not on a regular basis, anyway. And she gave up. Sold this for $16.50.
Are you kidding?
I drove down to South Carolina the next morning with three kids in my car.
It's got more than $16.50 in stainless steel on it.
I know, yeah. I told myself I'm coming. Yeah. I said I'm on my way. And I just wanted to show you that, guys. It shows that you're that close, don't give up. You know, I mean, I'm happy because I got it for really cheap, but, you know.
Yeah, but it says a lot about, though, you can have bad days. I'm sure you've had bad days.
Oh, jeez.
And then, but overall,
last Tuesday, it rained at my bar location on Tuesday night. Mm-hmm. I think I did $30, guys. It happens, you know, it happens. But then, you know, Friday, I picked up a school event and served, I don't know, 50 or 60 lemonades, drinks, water bottles, and served over 100 people in a couple hours at a school and sold out for lunch too that day. So I mean, you have your days where I mean it all balances out. It's not about one day, one discouraging experience, you know.
All right, I'm gonna plug me here real quick and tell you what you can do, and I'm gonna plug Matt as well. You can Mark says he'll give you $2,200 for the car right now.
My All-American.
All right, here's the deal. You can come work with Matt. You can actually go to hotdogcartstore.com/day-in-the-life. And I'm going to ask Matt here in a minute what you can expect with that. But, of course you got to come to Knoxville, and he's got already people he's trying to schedule into his days. But we're going to make it even better. If you decide to get a cart from Hot Dog Cart Store in the first 30 days after your training, your free training, okay, which nobody does free training, you get free training. I'm going to give you $300 to offset your travel expenses for Anthony's driving 12 hours, he said, to come. And
hey, Anthony.
So y'all are going to have, you just got to, it's an awesome opportunity. It won't last forever, but I wanted you to be aware of it. What can they expect when they come,
guys,
Matt?
When you come, I'm going to what I've done so far for everybody is personalize the needs, because I've had guys that have been running carts for a couple years come and work with me. They still want to come and work with me for new ideas. A gentleman just came over from the other side of Tennessee because he wanted to see the taco menu. So he came last Tuesday just to see
how
you can expand your menu, expand your menu and different things and catering. I've got an operating cart in North Carolina coming over for a wedding because they wanted to see how, to get into catering and do weddings and such like that with a cart. So it's going to be customized. I've had guys, John down in Florida, he just came up and then he found a cater pro down there a couple days later, but he didn't own a cart, so it was different for him. It was looking over his
business.
So it's
not a cookie cutter.
It's not a cookie cutter thing because everyone's different. You're going to be at different levels. Do we need to look at your locations? Do we need to look at that? I can teach you how to run a cart physically, and that's why I tell people the cool part of it or the romantic part of it is actually serving people and doing that stuff. But that's really the easy part. And that's, the thing that you got to get. There's a lot of stuff that's kind of harder that I can help you with real quick, that just because you didn't even know it was going to be a problem.
Right.
But things like, getting your names ready, your business plan, contacting your health departments, showing you how to market to businesses like this, how to go inside. I mean, I took one gentleman with me on a marketing day, and we just did marketing. We went and gave business cards out and talked to businesses and got a catering, and it showed them how you can expand your business via that way. So it's not just, how you serve a hot dog or how do you turn the cart on. To be honest, that's the easy part. Ben's got videos that can show you how to turn a hot dog cart on and light a match, but the reality of running it is a little differently. I generally try to do a phone call ahead of time for an hour or so and try to get a game plan. I ask you bring a notepad and something. One vendor, we did 2 days together. We went and visited other hot dog vendors in Knoxville and showed the good and the bad. We really literally wrote pros and cons list for each vendor we visited.
Wow.
And ate hot dogs at. And I took him to a guy at a Home Depot in West Knoxville that literally kills. He makes a ton of money, but he's got one of the worst setups you'll ever see in your life. We sat there and just watched him. He could double his business if he ran it right.
Right.
I showed, him that, hey, you can do the wrong thing and end up lucky, but I wouldn't count on that.
Right.
And that's reality is it is hard work. People fail in this business because they don't expect it to be hard work. So I want to show you what comes in behind that. It's not just 2 hours a day. Yeah, I got here at 11 to, about 10:45 and I'm pretty much ready to leave, by 1. But there's a lot more that goes into it, behind the scenes, especially when you're first starting out. I mean, if you can make it,
but it, what?
Your first year, you learn so much.
A big obstacle for people is, and I have a video called, oh shit, I got a hot dog cart, now what? Well, the reason why is because you get a cart, it sounds good. And then even if you did all your homework, your due diligence, then you go out and you get your cart, and then that fear sets in.
Oh, yeah.
Well, coming and visiting with you,
oh, yeah.
The fear's gone.
That's gone because you can't – what are you going to do, screw up a customer you're never going to see again?
Right.
But most of mine, as you might have seen today, most of my customers, you come with me and you can serve my customers. Most of mine know me and have – I bring you to this location. These people know my family, my baby, my wife. They my kids serve them drinks in the summer. They're not going to be offended and anything happens, but
yeah, but they really, you really can't screw up. It's just part of life.
It's really not. Yeah. I mean, you can't, I've literally had one in 3 years now. I've had one customer that wasn't satisfied and I just gave them their meal for free and, no bad complaints or anything
right.
like that. And, it just, I think I had, ran out of, I think it was a taco a couple weeks ago and they ran out of sour cream and it was just, I had a little there. But she wanted a big old dollop on her taco, and, things happen, a lot worse. But I would highly recommend it. When I started out, when most people started out, you didn't have that opportunity to go.
Oh, I would have done this. I'd have paid $1,500, $2,000 to come spend time with a real vendor.
Our previous rates for this, we're running $600, $900, for a day to 2 days for, consultations, And
right.
this is free, guys. Coming out, I don't mind. The schedule is getting booked up, so I recommend.
Book
and,
now,
Burke
Early.
And I'll be honest, fill that thing out today if you can, because tomorrow night is probably when I'm going to be sitting down to make to look at the emails for make my next schedules. I'll probably be contacting the next few people. I've got people asking me for March. I mean, so
yeah.
I mean, I've still got some winter vending, you know, open if people want to see that. If you got Christmas time and stuff, you know, Christmas vacations coming up, I don't stop vending. I'm going to be doing some strange stuff coming up in November and December, you can see too. So if you're interested in catering, marketing, different ways to do things, on-site caterings, I've got a lot of that stuff coming up in November and December.
Be an awesome opportunity for people that are going,
you know, yeah, I mean,
that want the experience.
I mean, it'll be different stuff too. You know, like I said, I've got people come work for me for a wedding from North Carolina on the 15th. We're doing an Oktoberfest wedding. It's going to be bratwurst and hot dogs and sauerkraut and
wow.
stuff like that, and they're coming over to that. It's a 110 person wedding.
Y'all can get sign up at hotdogcartstore.com/DIL. That's day in life, DIL. hotdogcartstore.com/DIL.
And guys, if you can't do the travel, sign up. You know, I'm doing a phone one. I got with a gentleman from Alaska. I got to set up some more times with him. He wasn't able to really to make the trip because he wants to start vending in Alaska. So, you know.
And we've got a few vendors in Alaska.
And there are vendors in Alaska, you know.
Yeah.
He's got to fly out. He said he's got to fly out of his city to another city and then fly.
Yeah, hop. Yeah, to get on a real plane. Well, Matt, I appreciate it a ton. That was fun. And I hope y'all enjoyed it. And I'll be back because we filmed other stuff while I was here. And I think it's still going, the 360 camera. And we'll have fun. I'm glad y'all are here. We already talked about the location about 22 times. I mentioned it. Just watch this video and you'll hear it. Thanks a bunch. Talk to y'all later.
Take care.